information that is given in the text. What is our opinion? What we think of it, or what we can infer from it? What other thoughts come to our mind on the basis of that information? So we have to learn to segregate the facts from the opinion, right? And so you've got those kind of questions. So maybe arranging in sequence also. Okay, what happened before or what happened later? You got questions from your writing skills and you had your grammar part also. Okay, so do you want me to discuss the answers? Do you want me to discuss the answers with you all? Okay, so all of you, yes, here. Let me see here and okay, fine. Where's my test? Yes, here it is. So how was Lencho an ox of a man? So first tell me, is it a simile or is it a metaphor? Lencho an ox of a man. It's a metaphor, isn't it, right? So he was not like an ox. It was, you can say, he was a hard-working person. So how is he compared to an ox, right? He looked like an ox, only he had an ox. He used only an ox in the field, or he worked like an ox? He worked like an ox, right? Then Lencho thought only of one hope. It was what? When did he think about it? When did he think about it? Dhruv is absent today? How did that happen? Yes? Dhruv and Amritpal. Amritpal is not joined also online. So six students are offline. I just write. Okay. Yes. Good morning, Dhruv. We say good morning to our teachers. We don't say hello and hi. Okay. Right, I'm not still so casual with my students, right? Yes, good morning, good morning. That's much better. So Lencho had only one hope. What was that hope? That hope was from God. This you all know, parents we are. Okay, ye tumko pata hai. Right, now pick the options that correctly classify facts and opinions. Okay, what are facts? Please remember, what are the facts? Information that is given. Opinion is what you think about that. Okay, now here it is. Lencho was surprised when he received the letter. He was feeling contented. Let me write them down. Should I write them down? Yes. Okay. So A is Lencho was, I'll just write, you know, like a little bit of it so that you have an idea. So Lencho was surprised when he received the letter. Okay. Then he was, feeling contented. Why should he have felt content? No, he was angry. Yes, he was angry. Why was he angry? Because he did not get his 100 pesos. Okay. And yes, he was, but at the office employees. Okay. Right. Now here, we have our facts. Let us decide which are the facts over here. Which is a fact? D is there. Okay. And this is a fact or not? He was surprised. Was he surprised when he received the letter? Because he was expecting it. So is this a fact? No, let's put a cross on it. Then yes, he was feeling content. When did he feel content? When was he content? He was not. He was not happy with the 70 pesos. So is this right or wrong? Wrong. Okay, fine. Then we have, no, he was angry because the money was less. It's correct? Yes, he was correct. Angry. Then yes, he was angry on the post office employees. Yes. So we, what are the things that we know from the chapter? The first two or the last two? Last two. So which one are the facts? Last two. So please here, let us do little tips and tricks, you know. Try to identify, yes, I've got this. What is the question here? Okay, fine. Yes, is it visible now? Can you see the board? Okay, fine. Thank you for telling me. That's good. Okay, yes, can you see the board now, students? So, who, I don't know who comes and moves the camera. So I'm looking at suspicion with the students here in the classroom. They do something. Okay, let's move the camera. Let's, you know, temper with the mic. So something will happen in the class. I'm going to teach you anyway. Don't worry. Right? So here, please, little tips and tricks. If you find that it is going to take a lot of time, like here, facts and opinions, or we have sequence ones, you know, the questions which are there. Please, I identify at least one correct option you're very confident about. Select that option, right? Is the answer over there in one, any of the options? And then you can see the other things there. Arranging a sequence and things there. So half your work is done. Because when you're doing multiple questions, we need to save time also, right? We can't spend so much of time on one question only. So we have a fact. So which is the fact, C and D? And this is the opinion. These are things that we have, you know, like a thought of that this is what should have happened. Okay, next one. Very easy. The title Black Aeroplane is based on an aeroplane that hit the pilot, the pilot's aeroplane, aeroplane in the stormy sky, or a dark colored aeroplane. The aeroplane that hit the pilot. It is not any aeroplane that was there in the sky. Okay, so it was about the aeroplane that hit. Okay. And what, which aeroplane was that? It was the black aeroplane. Now, paper has more patience than people. What does this imply? Paper has more patience. Who speaks these words? It's from the diary of a young girl. It's from Anne Frank. What does she say? Why is paper more patient? Because what did Anne believe? What did she believe? The power of writing more than speaking? That she could pour her heart out on paper? She had more faith in sharing her thoughts and feeling, or felt that she could share her feelings openly on paper. She had more faith, you know, like that in, which one? That she could share her feelings open-heartedly. Okay, fine, correct. That she could share her feelings. But paper is there because paper is not going to object. So I think here that she could pour her heart out. She could say whatever she want to, as long as she want to, did do, because people will listen for some time and then they'll get bored, right? So paper will not get bored. That is the main thing. Why does she say patience? I'm going to listen there. They're going to be there. Okay, let's do the next one. What was the pilot looking forward to? He wanted to reach his destination. He wanted to meet his family. His holiday, or two and three? Both are given, both two and three. Yeah, nothing was mentioned about the holiday here. So we have a little problem over here. Actually, it is, right? What is more mentioned here? That he wanted to have that English breakfast and he wanted to be with his family. He was such a hungry person. So he had no problem at all. He, you know, what... went to the storm and the clouds also, right? So to meet his. Actually, based on what is given over here. It is because B, to reach his destination, was it? And to meet his family, his holiday, or two and three. It is, I think B would be the option then, to meet his family. This holiday, it's nothing mentioned there. To meet his family is wrong. Okay, then both two and three. Both two and three to meet his family and his holiday. Right? Okay. Yeah, actually, yes. So nothing is mentioned in the chapter. It is there. Beginning, it is mentioned somewhere that he's going from Paris. He's going over there and he was on that holiday or something. Yeah. So just have a look at the beginning, first paragraphs which are there. All of you at home also take a look. Right. Next one. If the diary were a real friend, what qualities would Anne expect it to have? Take the option that lists these correctly. One is optimistic. What is optimistic? What is optimistic? Positive, right? Someone who has a positive outlook towards, right? So would you want a friend who's optimistic, a good listener, confident, energetic, non-judgmental, outgoing, ambitious? So seven qualities are there. If we, Anne thought of a friend, one is optimistic, four is energetic, right? Five, six, and seven, non-judgmental, outgoing, ambitious, good listener, confident, and non-judgmental. Yes, yes. So two, three, and five. Optimistic ke saath, baaki options kya hai? One ke saath, it is energetic. That is not, we need more, right? So we need more qualities here. Right, Shantanu? Why do you think Mr. Keesing chose the title An Incorrigible Chatterbox for Anne to write on? This was so because he expected what? Yes, can I get answers from you all? What did you write? Tell me your responses. You didn't write? You didn't do? No? So why did he choose the title? What does incorrigible chatterbox mean? Someone please tell me, what does it mean, incorrigible chatterbox? So someone who cannot change, or someone who cannot control a certain quality, that is incorrigible. Chatterbox, person talks too much. So someone who cannot stop from talking, okay? So, and to express her inability to elaborate on such, because he thought she would be unable to, but Anne did, right? That this would embarrass Anne and check her. Yes, he wanted her to apologize and not repeat her talkative behavior. Did he ever ask her to say sorry? He just said and give the, right? Or Anne to explore her creative writing skills. I think so. It is B. Yes. It is B, that he wanted her to realize, you know, to feel embarrassed that I talk so much, I need to keep quiet. Isn't it? Right. Now, which is odd one out, which does not mean something similar to patience? Indolence, tolerance, grit, bear. Indolence, absolutely. So you should know. Indolence is, I would say maybe rudeness. Grit is your determination, you know, like, yeah, you are there, you're bearing everything. Peggy gave her friend a nudge because. When did this happen? When did Peggy give her friend a nudge? What is nudge? A small push. Move away. When? She wanted to push her away from the scene. She disliked her friend from being distracted then. She was teasing Wanda and wanted her to make what? She was teasing Wanda and didn't want anyone her to. Yes. Which one is it? She was teasing Wanda and didn't want anybody, or she didn't want this to happen. Yes. In the opinion of the judges, any of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. I think so. Last one, D option is the right one. She was teasing Wanda and didn't what? It's not showing complete the option. Now, in the opinion of the judges, any of the drawings is worthy of winning the prizes. Now, here, yes, unfortunately, Wanda has been absent for some days and is not here to receive the applause. Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. Now, class, you may file around the room quietly and look at her exquisite drawings. Statement that is true. Wanda won the prize because she has submitted a number of drawings. Wanda would have still won the prize even if she had not submitted so many. Wanda won the prize because the majority of the judges, what? Can you see the complete answer? Wanda would still have won the prize if she had drawn one or two. I think yes, the last one is the correct one. What reason did Mandy give herself to justify teasing Wanda? Yes, that Wanda used to lie about. Wanda deserved it. That she thought that Wanda was too dumb to understand and Wanda will not. See, but yes. What tells you Peggy wasn't cruel? She protected small children from bullies. She did not make Wanda cry. She couldn't stand animals getting mistreated, all of the above. But did not make Wanda cry is not there. Right? So that is not the option there. Right? But Wanda, it's never been shown also in the chapter that did she cry, Wanda, did she cry? Also. All of the above, it is better. Because it all are there. Because the A and C option is not given. Because the A and C option is not given, isn't it? Guard asked, who are you? The guard asked who he was. The guard asked me. Narration. Please change it. The guard asked who I was. Was. Past. Right? So last one. Now, which of the following did the young girl not feel according to the given context? All day he watched his brother, parents flying about with his brothers and sisters. He just watched them. What did he not feel? Sad? Incompetent? Sad is, look, I can't fly. Incompetent? I can't fly. I'm not able to fly. Excluded? I want to be with them. Right? Ungrateful? Let's see, my parents have done so much for me and I should at least get up and fly. Did you feel ungrateful at all? Inspired. Look at them flying. I want to fly. Jealous. Oh my God, they're flying. I want to fly too. Anxious. Why am I unable to fly? Was he anxious? No. What was he doing? He was hiding. Like, of course. Yes. So what was he? Was he ungrateful? Was he sad, excluded, or jealous? Was he incompetent, inspired, anxious? Was he incompetent, excluded, anxious? Anxious is there in every one of the options, but fourth, fifth, and sixth. Ungrateful, inspired, jealous. What do you have to say? It was not actually ungrateful, isn't it? Ungrateful, inspired, and jealous. Okay, I think so here. The others, you can just go through it. Right? So let me just discuss a few things with you all. Now here, from your writing skills, please now here, just tell me here. Again, what are we going to do tomorrow? We don't have any poetry this time. No poems in this test. Next time we have the test. So I think so in our next test, we should start discussing the poems. Right? So please bring your books with you all. I'll be sharing the screen and we'll be framing multiple choice questions. Okay. I am not, maybe it says they're from the sample paper and all, fine, good enough, but I will be discussing a few things in the class. I don't know. How can that happen? Nobody does that. Nobody does that. Yeah, no. Nobody does that. Right? Okay, one thing is this. Yeah? Yeah, little bit options were there. But yes, one thing is there, you have an idea what questions you got. I think so it is a fantastic test and it has made you wake up and realize there's a lot to study. And even if we are able to do that 1%, I think submission is accomplished. Right? So it's a successful mission, part one. Now let's see what happens with part two. Okay, now here, what am I going to do? Please, tomorrow we are going to do two poems. One is Dust of Snow and one is Fire and Ice. What I want you to do for Dust of Snow, can there be any sequence questions? Can we have sequence? Yes. Can I have facts and opinions? Yes. Can I have reasons and statements? Yes. So I can. And of course, what am I going to focus on? I am going to focus on literary devices. I am also going to focus on beyond the text. Because when we're doing poetry, there are a lot of feelings, there are a lot of emotions. So when we discuss about Dust of Snow, if you have to do the sequence of the events here, this is the simple easiest thing to do, a sequence. So easy it is. Yes? Agree with me? If we've read the chapter, if we've read the poem, otherwise we don't know where it started and where it ended. Okay? Right. Yes, here. Yeah. So what are the things that we have to remember in the poem? We have the hemlock tree. We have the crow and we have the snow, right? Okay. Yes. What does this mean? Dust of the where did these fine particles fall from? The tree, the hemlock tree. Okay, right. So when we talk about the hemlock tree and the crow, are they symbolic of anything? What are they symbolic of? They are symbolic of evil and bad things and things we should stay away from. Crow is a, like, of course, you talk about death. When you talk about the hemlock tree, it is poisonous. We stay away from it. But did anything bad happen to the poet when he went near the did he get electrified or did he get poisoned or something? Did anything happen to him? Nothing happened. It was perfectly normal. How did he come back after that experience? Happy, became a better person. In fact, he realized that thank God this happened to me. Otherwise, considering the sad, dejected mood I was in, I would have wasted this whole day. And it is not a nice thing to waste one day of your life. Each day is so important. Okay. So what do we have to say if I talk about facts and opinions once again? We have here, hemlock tree is poisonous. This is a fact. If I say that standing near the hemlock tree brings us bad luck, it's an opinion, or it's a belief, it's a superstition, isn't it? Because when we read this poem, nothing of that sort happened to the poet, right? Standing near, of course, the hemlock tree is poisonous. Standing near the hemlock tree can give us enlightening thoughts. Can it give us? No. But then how did it happen to the poet? The crow made him think. So there has to be a crow on the hemlock tree when we stand near it. The crow is responsible for bringing good thoughts. Snow is responsible for bringing good thoughts. So many things here. So which is the real thing? Is it that the poet was present when at the right place, at the right time? He had got all his combinations correct? Yes. And is it a rare coincidence that might not happen again? Yes. Or is it our beliefs and thinking that we need to change? Say yes for everything and you get a big no for the answer. Right? Yes, Shantanu? What about it? The crow makes us feel positive. We can think better on a snowy day. No. Sunny day maybe we soch sakte hum log. Rainy day maybe we soch sakte hain. Cloudy day maybe we soch sakte hain. So why snow here? It is that little moment here. Little things can bring about a change. You know, right? Yes. So here it is. So something positive has happened there. You know, like of course you were there maybe feeling a little upset, but something positive happened. It changed your outlook. So what is that? That could be anything. That trigger could be anything that can give you that positivity. Okay. Right. So please write down the sequence of events which happened when took place. What was it? What was the last thing that happened? Poet had. Okay, positive thoughts, right? Then before that, what was it? He was depressed, okay, or upset. Yeah, I would use upset. Then by chance, where did he go? He near the hemlock tree. And then what happened over there? Yes, a crow came. And of course, sat on the branch. And then there was a dust of snow. How is a dust of snow different from a snowstorm? Yes, how is... Yes, so dust of snow is like the snow which was there on the branch, it fell and, right, so he was there, you know, as he shook off the dust, do you think he shook off his negativity also? He shed his negativity also? So the little tiny thing that happened and it brought that happiness to his mind and it brought him positivity. Okay, so if you had to hear, we have done your facts and opinions. We have here symbolism, right? Okay, are you able to identify alliteration? Are you able to identify alliteration? I can see a shaking head. What is alliteration? Should I call a class 6 student to tell us what is alliteration? Alliteration is a repetition of a consonant sound. Okay? Repetition of a consonant sound. I slip, I slide, right? Okay, so yes, fine. Then what is the repetition of a vowel sound caused? Called, it is called azo. Okay, you have to remember. There are examples of anaphora also, right? What is that? When the first word is repeated in every line in consecutive line, not necessarily in all. Some say it will end in fire. Some say it will end in ice. Right? So what is sum over here? It is anaphora. Okay? So repetition is that word is repeated. Alliteration is a sound that is repeated. I hope you will not forget this. Okay? So see you all and please keep your poetry ready. Right? Keep your books ready tomorrow. We discuss the poems. Thank you.